Hello everyone. I'm gonna share you today some few information about airways in India, about pilot and cockpit crew hirings in India. So let's start. Hello, I'm Roshni Maji, HR manager at Aircruise Aviation Private Limited, and these are my social media handles. You can contact me there also. Today's content topics that are airlines, qualification, hiring process, what is the selection process, responsibilities, benefits, and payments. So these are the major airlines in India. You can see there are IndiGo, Air India, SpiceJet, AirAsia, and many more. These are all Indian Airway logos. You can see in the screen. So, airports in India. So, in this map, you can see there are so many airports which is marked over here, from Srinagar, from Leh to Thiruvananthapuram. So, this many airports are there in all over India. There are many domestic and international airports. So this is the mix of all the types of airports. So aviation in India. So basically there are two types of aviation. First is military aviation and the second is civil aviation in India. So you can choose either of them in India as your career. So careers as a pilot, as an aviator. So for commercial aviation, handles the following. First is passenger airlines. Second is cargo planes. The third is international air services. And fourth is air taxi character operations. Also, career as a pilot aviation. For military aviation, it includes the Indian Air Force and aviation arms of Navy and Army. So let us discuss some of the history of airlines. So the first commercial aviation flight in India took place on 18 February 1911. And regular air mail was not established until two decades later, notably by J.R.D. Tata, who was awarded a contract to carry mail in 1932 and founded an airline which grew to become Air India. So this is the main history of our Indian airlines. So airline jobs. First, the main jobs which you can get in airlines. There are table of contents. The first is flight attendant. Second is concessionaire. The third is air traffic control. Fourth is airport engineer. Fifth is airport planner. Also, it continues to be TSA, TSO, airport security member, air marshal, airframe or power plant mechanic, baggage or airline pilot. So what is the interview which you will be facing when you will be hiring? So the major airline job requirements are must have 300 hours total flight time. You should also at least 1,500 hours multi-engine and at least 1,000 hours as pilot in command of a turbine-powered aircraft. So these are the requirements which you should fulfill. About pilot. Pilot is not only a person who flies a plane, flies cockpit, but he is also a backbone of aviation industry. He is also responsible for checking the management of cockpit and his air regulation and planning flights. So he should follow air regulations and he should plan flights accordingly. So what is the pilot checklist? What is the pilot hiring process and requirements? So a day in the life of pilot, the minimum or median salary is $78,740. So in this, you will be getting a commercial pilot license, ability to adapt to unusual working hours and working conditions. Your vision should be 20/20, that is, your vision should be perfect, and exceptional interpersonal skills, and conduct business in a professional manner and demeanor at all time. So these are the requirements which will be needed. And also, this is the process of how to become a commercial pilot. So let's move on to the next slide. What is the qualifications? So for an Indian Air Force, the minimum qualification is SSC or HSC, that is normal secondary schooling or higher secondary schooling you should do. The minimum age is 18 years old, and excellent English language skills. That is, your English speaking skills should be very efficient. Your very high physical and mental fitness standards as defined by Indian Force, Indian Army Force. And you need to pass entrance exams to qualify for basic airmen. So these are the qualifications which you need to pass for an Indian Air Force. So for the private institutions, the qualifications are minimum qualifications should be also SSC or HSC. Maximum age is 18 years. And excellent English language skills should be there. Level 2 medical and mental fitness should be fulfilled by you. And also basic entrance exam of some of the private institute, you need to pass that also. So what are the expectations from a pilot? What are the expectations from a newcomer? So these are some of the list of values that you need to fulfill. The first is zeal to excel and zest for chance, for change. Integrity and fairness in all matters, strict adherence to commitments, ensure speed of response. You should respond to every questions which will arise in front of you. So you should answer that efficiently, foster learning and creativity and teamwork. So that's the main skill which you need. Loyalty and pride in the company, respect for dignity and potential of individuals. So these are the values and skills which you need. This is the specific eligibility criteria. So the subject combination is a science stream. You have to be from science stream, that is in 10+2, from 10+2, that is 12, in science stream with physics and mathematics as main subjects. Exams are IGRUA, ATPL, institution exams, some private institution exams, etc. And at least 50% in 10+2 system. So the role and responsibilities are calculating fuel, that's the main important thing, performing aircraft inspection before and after flying, choosing safe and efficient flying routes. Also, keep accurate documents for operating purpose, communication with the required agencies and employees, ensuring the safety and comfort of passengers, crew, and other members in aircraft. So daily pilot tasks. So these are some of the daily pilot tasks which you will be fulfilling. First is inform the crew about the flight details. Second is check out before takeoff. Report any broken systems. So you need to inform the crew that this part is broken, please sort it out. And fourth is requesting takeoff, landings, and follow-up with air train controllers. Also, fly the plane, monitor all system, fill the plane's documentary, keep in touch with air traffic control and other aircrafts, switch tasks with the co-pilot to avoid burnout. So these are the factory airlines and hirings. These are some of the tests which you need to give while you will be hiring hiring process. Also, type of job roles pilot. So for commercial pilot, it's passengers pilot, cargo pilot, and there is aerosports pilot. Type of job roles pilot. So in military pilot, there are Air Force pilots, Army pilots, and Navy pilots. Employment opportunities for pilots. So airline industries, you can find your employment opportunities in various industries. The first is airline industries. Second is Indian Armed Force, Indian Navy, Indian Air Force, transportation and logistic companies, drone providers and manufacturers. So this is the salary range. This is the estimated salary range which you will be expecting after you get a job in airlines industry. So for the basic salary per annum, you will, for a commercial pilot, it figure is given. So just refer to it. So after learning about, after giving information about hirings and job responsibilities of a pilot, you might be thinking that how much earn an air hostess earn? What is the process of hiring of an air hostess? So for this, we'll be discussing in the next video. So again, I'm Roshni Maji, HR Manager at Air Queens Aviation Private Limited. And thank you for watching this video.